This tutorial is going to cover using the Organizer tab to import data from one show file into another. And we're going to focus on the details of importing data into new show files and also into existing show files and where you need to be careful. The easiest way to do importing, of course, is to import into a brand new empty show file because there are no conflicts. If you import from an existing show file into another existing show file, it's possible that the numbers are going to conflict because they're the same preset number, the same palette number, the same group number, and so on. I'm going to show you a few tricks to getting around those conflicts and how you can tell the system not to be so careful about protecting your data if that's what you want to have happen. So we're going to start off very quickly with a new show file just to prove that we have nothing in the system, no patch, completely empty. Start from the beginning. For work I'm doing later, I'm going to change this bottom doc to the direct select doc, and we'll come back to that later. And then I'm going to import information that in this case goes along with our visualization file. So I'm going to go to the browser and open that up, and under files, import from, I'm going to pick my show file that goes with this visualization file from my Play Archive. Could also be on my USB memory or on a file server or anywhere on the system that way. But I'm going to pick this one on the hard drive. And what's going to happen then is I'm going to get two organizer views. Close the browser to get a little more room on the screen. The left organizer view is called Organizer Import From. And if you look in the middle of the screen, you'll see that there's a file path, Play Archive, and then the name of my show file. On the right-hand side, this is the organizer that is the show file in memory, the current show file. In other words, the completely empty show file we're starting from. So you'll see no names or no file path or anything like that because that's the current state of the console. Everything that's in the left-hand tab is on my hard drive, USB stick, etc. Everything that's in the right-hand side is in current memory. And what I'm going to do first, very simply, is I'm going to start by importing my patch. The patch can be imported very simply by dragging the patch item from the left onto the patch item on the right. And we always copy when we're importing. We're not moving information from the show file on the hard drive. We're simply copying information from that original source. And I'm going to hit copy. And in this case, it's a very big show file, and my dialogue's going to be very long, but it's going to basically take the entire patch of the system in one fell swoop and bring it over into my current show file. And I can scroll down and show you all the stuff that just came in, including all the definitions of the lights, the definition of our capture camera, all the patch information for that, and our dimmers. Basically, everything that's underneath this patch node was dragged over and dropped into the new show file at once. And you saw that our visualization file popped into an existence because the patch now matches between the two systems. What I'm going to do next, then, because now I have some channels. So for example, if I look at my live view, zoom in a bit, you can see I have all of these channels in the system. And I can turn some lights on, as you can see. But let's say I also want to have some groups, because patching and groups normally fit together quite nicely. Now I'm going to just take pieces. I could, if I wanted to, drag the entire group segment into the new show file by clicking here and dragging to there. That would bring every group in the original file into my new file. But in this case, I'm going to do some playful things, and I'm going to select using my shift key and the arrows on my normal keypad. I could also use the select key and the arrows on my console keypad to select multiple items in this particular view, in this case, continuously numbered items. I can then drag them over onto groups in my current show file. And you can see now I have a list in this dialog of the three groups that I had originally selected, which channels are going to be included in those groups. And I can just make a copy. Very simple. So now I have groups 1, 2, 3, and here I have groups 1, 2, 3. But what if I also wanted to have, for example, some other groups? and at other numbers. I could do the same thing, shift in the arrow or select in the arrow, drag them over. But let's say I don't want them to start at group 6. I want to start them at group something else, let's say 11 in my current show file. What I can do is come into the Advanced tab, and I can use this renumber mode. Keep original spacing and gaps, which in this case doesn't matter because they're consecutively numbered anyway. And I want to start them at number 11. And then I press copy. And so now you can see group number 6 in the original file has become group number 11 in my current show file. So this is a way you can move things around. But wait, there's more. I can, just for grins, let's say select using the control key instead these odd number groups, 11, 13, 17, and 19, and drag them over and go into my Advanced tab. If I want to keep the gap, keep them as odd numbers, but start them, let's say, at number 31, I can do that. And so now you can see number 11 has become number 31, number 13 has become number 33, and so on. Or, again, just as an example, I can select the evens, bring them over here, and now instead of keeping the original spacings and gaps, I want to convert to consecutive numbers. So this is a way to get rid of gaps that might have been created in the original show file. And I'll start at number 41. And so now you can see the original group 12 led front has become group 41 led front. The original group 16 has become group 42, and so on. So this is a way of completely rearranging how your show has been organized, if that's the kind of thing you'd like to do. This works for groups or palettes, and also for presets, I believe. So just to show what happened here, I'm going to open up my Direct Select doc and show you the 100 button array of the group set here. And now you can see we imported the first three. They're at 1, 2, 3. And then you can see these other groups have been imported and show up now on their new numbers. And just as always, because the patch was there and the groups came in second, I have the ability to control those groups now directly from my Direct Select panel. So going back to our organizer view, I'm going to talk a little bit about importing presets. I'm going to roll down here out of the way and pick a few presets to import directly into the preset list. So here's just a set of four presets numbered, unfortunately, consecutively. So I'm going to cheat, and I'm going to select some presets to import, but I'm going to skip a few so that we have some gaps. So I have 220, 222, and 230. And I'm going to bring them over into the preset section here. As you can see, once again, I get an indication of what it is I'm copying. And you can see we have the same types of options in the Advanced tab of the drop dialog. So I can keep the original spacing and gaps. I can convert these to consecutive numbers, for example. And I can start at some nice, ridiculous number like 1001, just to have a dramatic renumbering, and hit copy. And you can see this is what's been brought over. This is dependent information. Presets contain intensity information and attribute data, and that includes palette data. So in this particular show file, what have we done so far? We've imported the patch, we've imported some groups, and now I've imported some presets. We never once stopped and imported any palettes. The act of importing a preset, in this case, brings the dependent data with it. And that ensures that when you play what's now going to become preset 1001, that you get a look on stage that looks like the original preset that you copied from. So this is just giving you an indication of all of that extra data, that non-preset data that came along with. So I'm going to close that, and we're going to look in our preset list now, and we're going to see we had three original presets here. And we said, renumber them, please. Get rid of the gaps, right? Use consecutive numbers. And so I have a nice clean set of new preset numbers, 1001, 1002, and 1003, that are copies of the original. So if we look at sequences, right, one step up from presets, and I want to bring a sequence over, it's going to do the same thing. When I look at preset 105, you can see it's got three presets in it. And when I drag preset 105 over into my sequences segment of my current show file, I don't have the renumbering options. It's going to keep the sequence intact because there's a lot of relationships established in that sequence. But I do get here the choice of looking at how I'm going to bring data in from this sequence. The system's default is to protect you from overwriting things inadvertently. So the default, the first item here is to bring in all data, but protect from dependencies conflicts, which means that it will not, by dragging these presets in, override existing palettes, for example. Or by dragging this sequence in, if it's using presets that have the same number as something that exists in your show file, it's going to stop and say there's a conflict here. This is especially true, not in this case necessarily, where we're importing into a brand new show file, but if you're importing into an existing show file, where you bring in a sequence that uses numbers that are similar to what already exists in your show file. The protect from dependencies conflicts option is keeping you safe. The second option, all data ignoring dependencies conflicts, will overwrite information. It will take the new palette and overwrite the old palette of the same number. It'll take the new preset and overwrite the existing preset of the same number in the current show file. This is a brute force import. Use with care. I suggest before doing these kinds of imports, please, that you save a copy of your show file. Save with revision. Just save often through these steps, because if you do bring something in that overwrites something that you didn't intend to overwrite, you can just go back one step, basically, and get back to where you were. If you don't save in between, you could be playing with fire by importing data over other data as you go forward. So just be careful as you're working, or always be aware of what you're doing. And then the third option here is to allow you to import just the intensity information from a sequence into a new show file and ignore all the moving light data, ignore the palettes, ignore all the parameter data, etc. It could be because you're moving from one house to the next and using a different lighting rig with different palettes that might already exist in your show file. You just need to get the intensity information from your old show file into the new one. So those are the three options when importing a sequence across. And we'll just keep ourselves nice and safe. And then I'm going to hit copy. And it brings over, you'll notice, focus palettes. Focus palette number three in this case, because focus palette number three is referenced by one of the presets 120, 121, and 122. And now I have an empty sequence one in my current show file and a new sequence 105 that looks just the same as my original sequence 105 that I imported. And I can just carry on dragging those sequences in with or without brute force until I'm happy. And you notice more bits and pieces of my show file are arriving as I import more and more chunks of the data into the current show file. Anything you see in the organizer is an importable thing. So you can import layouts, scroller rolls, dimmer curves, fade curves, independents, macros, patch effects, and so on and so forth. I'll just say it again. Save your data often as you're doing this work, and it will keep you sane. But this is a very powerful tool. It does use a mouse for dragging and dropping. You can also do this with the keypad, but in all honesty, the mouse is much faster for this type of editing function. And that's how you use the organizers to import partial show data from one show into another.